In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet dividing polynomials. Our directions are to divide, and we're going to divide using long division. So number one, we have m squared minus 7m minus 11, that quantity divided by m minus 8. So we'll write m minus 8, and then m squared minus 7m minus 11. Now we're going to start with m. M goes into the term m squared m times. So now we're going to multiply m by m minus 8 and write that here. So m times m minus 8 is m squared minus 8m. And we're subtracting this. M squared minus m squared is 0. So negative 7m minus a negative 8m will be a positive 1m. And we also have minus 11. So now starting with m again, we're going to see how many times m goes into 1m. And that's 1. So a positive 1. And now, same as before, we'll multiply this 1 to m minus 8. And 1 times m minus 8 is m minus 8. And that is also subtracted. 1m minus m is 0. Negative 11 minus negative 8 is going to be a negative 3. And m cannot go into 3, therefore our remainder is negative 3. So our solution will be m plus 1 minus 3 over m minus 8. So we just take our remainder, which is subtracting 3, or adding a negative 3, over that m minus 8. So our solution is m plus 1 minus 3 over m minus 8. On to number 2, we have n squared minus n minus 29, and we're dividing that by n minus 6. So again, we're looking at n, and how many times does n go into n squared? N goes into n squared n times. So we're going to take this n and multiply it by n minus 6. That'll give us n squared minus 6n, and we're subtracting that. So n squared minus n minus n squared minus 6n, n squared will cancel out. Negative n minus negative 6n is going to be a positive 5n, and we're still subtracting 29. Now we have to see how many times n goes into 5n, and that's 5 times, and it's a positive 5. So now we're going to take that positive 5 and multiply it by n minus 6, and subtract that quantity. So 5 times n minus 6 is 5n minus 30. And we're subtracting that, so 5n will cancel out, and negative 29 minus negative 30 is a positive 1. So this time, our remainder, I'll say r, is 1. So our answer is n plus 5 plus, since our remainder is positive, 1 over n minus 6. N plus 5 plus our remainder of 1 over n minus 6. And number 3, n squared plus 10n plus 18 divided by n plus 5. Looking at the n at the start, n goes into n squared n times. N times n is n squared. Then we're going to take this n and multiply it by n plus 5 and subtract that from our polynomial. So it'll be n squared plus 5n, and that's subtracted, so n squared will cancel out. 10n minus 5n is a positive 5n, and we're still adding that 18. Now, looking back at n, that goes into 5n, a positive 5 times. So 5 times n plus 5 is going to be 5n plus 25, and we're subtracting that, so 5n will cancel out. 18 minus 25 is a negative 7. So our remainder is negative 7. So our solution, n plus 5 minus, since our remainder is negative, 7 over n plus 5. So again, our answer is n plus 5 with a remainder of 7. So that's n plus 5 minus 7 over what we divided by, n plus 5. And number 4, We're dividing k squared minus 7k plus 10 by k minus 1. Starting with the k, k goes into k squared k times. So now we're going to multiply this k by k minus 1. That will give us k squared minus 1k. And we're subtracting that. So k squared will cancel out. Negative 7k minus a negative 1k will be negative 6k. And we're still adding 10. Now we're going to see how many times k goes into negative 6k. And that's negative 6 times, or we could just say subtracting 6 from k. So now we're going to take that negative 6 and multiply that to k minus 1. That'll be negative 6k plus a positive 6. And when we're subtracting this, our 6k's will cancel out, since negative 6k plus 6k is 0, and then 10 minus 6 is 4. So we have k minus 6 with a remainder of 4. Therefore, our final solution is going to be k minus 6 plus 4 over k minus 1. K minus 6 plus our remainder of 4 over k minus 1. In number 5, starting with n goes into n squared n times. So now we're going to multiply that n by n minus 7 and subtract that. N times n minus 7 is n squared minus 7n. And when we subtract that, our n squareds will cancel out. Negative 3n minus a negative 7n is a positive 4n, and we're subtracting that 21. Now, how many times does n go into 4n? N goes into 4n 4 times, and that's a positive 4. Now we're going to take that 4 and multiply it to n minus 7. 4 times n minus 7 will be 4n minus 28. And we're subtracting that. So our 4n will cancel out. Negative 21 minus a negative 28 is a positive 7. So our remainder is a positive 7. And you can see that our answer is n plus 4 with a remainder of 7. So we're going to write n plus 4 plus our remainder value over n minus 7, since that's what we divided by. N plus 4 plus 7 divided by n minus 7. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 6. In number 6, we have a squared minus 28. However, we're missing an a to the 1, or a value. So we're going to write a squared plus 0a minus 28. Since a squared plus 0a minus 28 is the same as a squared minus 28, since 0 times any number is 0. But we need that placeholder in there so we can divide. And we're dividing by a minus 5. So a goes into a squared a times, and then we multiply a times a minus 5 is a squared minus 5a. Now you can see why I put the placeholder in. A squared will cancel out. 0a minus negative 5a is a positive 5a. And we're still subtracting 28. Now we're going to see how many times a goes into 5a, and that's a positive 5. So we're going to take that positive 5 value and multiply it by a minus 5. 5 times a minus 5 is 5a minus 25. And when we subtract, 5a will cancel out, since 5a minus 5a is 0, and negative 28 minus a negative 25 is a negative 3. So we have a plus 5 with a remainder of negative 3. So writing out our answer, we're going to have a plus 5 minus, since the remainder is negative, 3 over a minus 5. Again, that's a plus 5 minus 3 over a minus 5. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here. Join me in the next video where I'll go over the next 7 problems on this worksheet. If you haven't already, click the subscribe button and give me a thumbs up if you found this video helpful. Also, if you need further explanation on dividing polynomials, go to my Algebra 1 tutorial section where I go more in depth with each step.